In this video, we will talk about adrenergic transmission. Let's get started. By adrenergic transmission, we mean neurotransmission by noradrenaline. But where do we see adrenergic transmission? It's mainly seen in the sympathetic postganglionic neuron. That means the noradrenaline is secreted by the postganglionic neuron at its contact with the effector organ. However, not all postganglionic sympathetic neurons show adrenergic transmission. There are some exceptions, like sweat glands and some vasodilator fibers. Certain areas of the brain also show adrenergic transmission. So this was some basics. Now, to see the steps involved in the adrenergic transmission, let's go to a terminal of a postganglionic sympathetic neuron. This is the nerve terminal of the postganglionic neuron. And this is the postsynaptic membrane from the effector organ, for example the heart. Everything starts with tyrosine. It is synthesized in the liver, from amino acid phenylalanine, by tyrosine hydroxylase. In the adrenergic neuron, it is taken up by active transport. In the cytoplasm of the neuron, the enzyme tyrosine hydroxylase converts tyrosine into DOPA. The DOPA is converted into dopamine by decarboxylase. In the nerve terminal, we have synaptic vesicles that take up this dopamine. This uptake is done by a carrier protein called vesicular monoamine transporter, or VMAT for short. In vesicles, we have an enzyme called dopamine beta hydroxylase. It converts dopamine into noradrenaline. Did you know this? That noradrenaline is synthesized inside the vesicle. The noradrenaline thus synthesized is complexed with ATPs. The complex is adsorbed on a protein called chromogranin. In this form, the noradrenaline is stored till it's time to release. And the time for release comes with impulse. When the neuron is stimulated, the vesicles release all its content. Along with noradrenaline, the ATP, chromogranin, and even the dopamine beta hydroxylase enzyme, which synthesized noradrenaline, is also released. The adrenaline acts on adrenergic receptors on the postsynaptic cell and initiates the response. So this is how adrenergic neurotransmission happens. Now let's see how the effect of noradrenaline is terminated. The main mechanism is reuptake in the nerve terminal. It occurs by a norepinephrine transporter on the neuronal membrane. 75 to 90% of the noradrenaline is taken up back this way. Now, the mitochondrial membrane contains an enzyme, monoamine oxidase. It degrades noradrenaline present in the cytoplasm. However, once inside the cell, the noradrenaline is quickly taken up into the vesicles by VMAT. So the degradation by monoamine oxidase is minimal. Thus, most of the noradrenaline is taken up back for reuse. Apart from that, the noradrenaline in the synaptic space may diffuse away. And this also contributes to the termination of its action. The noradrenaline that goes away this way is degraded by catechol-O-methyltransferase, or COMT for short. So this is all about adrenergic transmission. Now let's have a quick summary. Adrenergic transmission is mainly seen in sympathetic postganglionic neurons. It involves uptake of tyrosine, synthesis of DOPA, its conversion into dopamine, uptake of dopamine into the vesicle, synthesis of noradrenaline, its storage with ATP and chromogranin, nerve impulse coupled release, activation of the postsynaptic cell, reuptake of most of the noradrenaline into nerve terminal by NAT, uptake in vesicle by VMAT, and diffusion of some adrenaline away from the receptor site. So this is all about adrenergic transmission. You can find notes on this topic and explore our entire animation video library on our website. The links are in the description. If you find our content useful, hit like, comment, and share it with your friends and colleagues too. Thanks for watching. See you in the next video.